This profit and loss question has been taken again from SBI PO mains 2017 memory based question, and this table along with these two facts has been given to us. Following this table and these facts, there are five questions that we have to answer. We will take all of them one by one. With each question, I'll show this table and this so that we can just refer to it along with the question. Now he says, item 1, item 2, item 3, item 4, A, B, C, D, E is given, and certain figures in percentages are given to us. Interestingly, some figures are missing also. And these notes are important. Discounts by 5 shopkeepers are given above. A, B, C, D, E are the 5 shopkeepers. MRP of an item is same for all the shopkeepers. These are the discounts. And MRP is same. So item 1 has certain MRP. It is same for shopkeeper A, B, C, D, and E. Item 2 similarly has the same MRP. Item 3 has the same MRP. Item 4 has the same MRP. This doesn't mean all the 4 items have the same MRP. This means item 1 has same MRP throughout, whatever. Similarly, item 2 might have a different MRP, but that MRP is same for all the 5 shopkeepers. Likewise for item 3 and item 4. Some values are missing. That of course we can see. You have to calculate these values as per data given in the questions. Whenever required, we will calculate them. We will not calculate them initially. In fact, we can't also. We don't have anything except this table. So we will have to calculate them as per requirement as we go. Let us take the first question. If the profit percentage of seller A after selling item 2 is X percent and that of seller C for the same item is 2X minus 4%, and the ratio of cost price of item 2 by seller A, so the same item is being togged, and seller C, the cost price of this item for A and C sellers is 17:21. And the profit percentage is given to us when they sold the item 2. And we have to find out the value of X. This is the question, which you can reread also. And let us now set to solve it. The best starting point would be to write the cost price for seller A and seller C. Because profit percentage is given, we will need the cost price. So let us write the cost price to seller A is equal to 17k. The ratio is given, so we can say 17k, k is some constant value. And cost price for item B for seller C, I'll just correct it. Cost price to seller C is equal to 21k. So we have the cost price for A and cost price for seller C. The item is 2. We are on this and on this one. Okay. Next he says, profit percentage. So since profit percentage is togged, we will need the sale price also. Marked price for item 2 is same for both of them. You can either assume the marked price as 100. Because concrete figures are not given, 100 is possible. But if you are confused by 100, you can assume any convenient, let us say M. Let us say marked price is equal to M. Now, if marked price is M, then the discount is 32%. So what is the sale price going to be? Sale price is going to be marked price minus 32% of the marked price, because discount is always on the marked price. So it is M minus 32 M by 100. This figure now might be difficult to handle. So my presence of mind says that I will take marked price as marked price as 100M will ensure that this 100 gets cancelled out. Just a trick, nothing else. We could have taken any convenient price. Somebody would take 100 only. That would simplify everything. But many students are not comfortable with 100. So I am taking it as some general figure, 100M. So sale price for the seller A is going to be 100M, the marked price, minus the discount 32 by 100 into 100M. Marked price is 100M, so 100M appears here also and here also. So this is equal to, this 100 cancels, so you get 68M as the sale price for the seller A. Sale price for seller B is similarly going to be, C. I'll just erase it, committing the same mistake. Sale price for seller C is similarly going to be, you can see 100 minus 16. It will be on the same lines, 84M. Because marked price will be 100M for the item 2, whether it is sold by seller A or seller C, the marked price will be 100M only. This is already given in the statement of the question. So sale price for seller A is 68M and for seller C is 84M. Their cost prices are also there. Now let us fit whatever is given us. Selling item 2 is X percent. Profit percentage for seller A is X percent. So what we can say is, what is profit percent? Sale price 68M. Minus the cost price. The cost price is 17k. Divided by the cost price. Sale price minus cost price by cost price is equal to X by 100. X percent, so we will write it as X by 100. So what we can do is, we can write, therefore, bring 17k before 68m, so that we don't have too many unknowns on this side, some cancellations can occur. So you can write 4m by k, because 17 4 68m by k, this will give me minus 1, is equal to x by 100. This is one equation that we can keep on our one side. Let us write the profit percentage for the seller C. Sale price for seller C is 84M. 84M minus the cost price is 21K divided by the cost price of 21K is equal to 2X minus 4 divided by 100, the profit percentage. Therefore, now this will cancel on 4, 4m by k minus this 1 is equal to 2x minus 4 by 100. This is the equation 2. Now I think you can see that the left hand side of equation 1 and equation 2 is same, 4m by k minus 1, 4m by k minus 1. So we can equate the right hand sides and we can write x. So when you equate, this 100 will get cancelled out. X will be equal to 2x minus 4. Therefore, you can take x to the other side. X is equal to 4. which is the required answer. So this is how we can take up this question. You can see yourself, steps are not many, but a person having a good understanding of mathematical solutions will be able to do it much easier, especially this, the division that I took here. Otherwise things are going to complicate into an endless whirlpool. So this one is a bit of presence of mind that is required. Let us move to the next question now. This question says, the same data is there for seller D, this one. Difference between sale price of item 2 and item 3. You have to go for these two places, is 420. If the sum of MRP of item 2 and item 3 by the same seller is 6000, then the MRP in rupees of item 2 is what percent more or less than that of item 3 by the same seller? So what I can see is that you have to find a relation between the MRP of item 2 and item 3. By what percent there are more or less. So we can start by writing MRP of item 2. We can take this MRP as, let us say, 100M, for the same reason that I told you in the previous question, why I am taking 100, so that calculations simplify. Similarly, of item 3, let it be 100N. Two MRPs, M and N, in terms of 100. Now, difference between sale price of item 2 and item 3. The sale price of item 2 will be, I'll just calculate for one of them, sale price of item 2 will be marked price 100M minus 28% of 100M. We could have calculated it much orally, but just to show the steps, this is equal to, so 100 cancels 100 minus 28, this is going to be 72M. Similarly, the sale price of item 3 will be 16 minus 100 story, 84N. The marked price of item 3 is 100N, so N will come here. Now what he has given is the difference. Again, he has given sale price of item 2 is more than sale price of item 3. So 72M minus 84N is equal to 420. We can use some cancellation on the table of 12. 12,672, 12,784 is equal to 12,336 and 35. This is one equation that we get. Let us take further. Sum of MRP of item 2 and item 3 is 6000. MRPs are 100M, 100N. So we have been given 100M plus 100N, this sum is equal to 6000. Therefore, you can cancel 100M plus N is equal to 60. This is our second equation. We need to find M and N first, so that we can find out the percentage more or less. One way is to multiply equation 2 by 7 and add these equations. This 7n will get cancelled and I'll be able to find out the value of m. So we can say 6m plus 7m should be equal to 35 plus 60 into 7. That is, M should be equal to, this is 455 by 13, which is equal to 35. And if M is 35, your N will come to 60 minus 35, which is equal to 25. So we can say the marked prices are respectively 3500, because marked price is 100M and 2500. Now he says, what is the percent, then MRP of item 2 is what percent more or less than that of item 3? Item 2 is this 100N, so it is less by 3500 minus 2500 divided by this 100N and 2500 multiplied by is less than that of item 3. Item 2 is less, 35, it is more, 3500 minus 2500 by 2500 than that of item 3. So the base is item 3. You see, 2500 comes down because base is item 3, which is 100N. So that is why this 2500 is the denominator. The difference is 3500 minus 2500. Read it again. Item 2 is what percent more or less than that of item 3? Item 2 is this one. Item 3 is this one. This is how much more? 3500 minus 2500 divided by, the base is item 3, so this one, multiplied by 100, which is equal to, so you can calculate it, 1000, which comes to 40%. So 40% is the required answer in this case. A bit of calculation, but if you see, it's not much, also a few equations and all, but again practice is required. So let us move to the next question. Now the same data, average selling price of item 2 by item 2, this is what we are talking, by seller A and seller B is rupees 3888. Discount in case of seller A is known, but not in case of seller B. We might expect some problem here. And by seller B and C is this much, the average sale price. Find the sale price of item 2 by seller C. The whole story is about item 2. We can just write marked price of item 2. Let us again take it as 100M to simplify our calculations. About this we are not aware. Let us also write it as X percent, so that we will use it as X and we'll proceed on the basis of that to find the answer to this question. That's all we can do. Okay. Average sale price of item 2 by seller A and B is this much. What is the sale price by seller A? Discount is 32%. Just like we have seen in the previous questions, this sale price by seller A is going to be 100M minus 32% of 100M, which ultimately comes to 68M. I have directly written it. You can yourself calculate and check it out. And what is the sale price by seller B? It will be, the discount is X percent. So can I write it as 100 minus X to simplify my things? You see, it's a presence of mind. I won't have to deal with 100 minus X here. I can just write 100 minus X here. might be a bit difficult to understand, because after all, the sale price comes after subtracting 100 from 32. So I'm directly writing 100 minus X here, so that sale price of item B, sale price of item 2 by seller B, it will come as XM. And let us also write the sale price of the same item by seller C side by side. Sale price by seller C is equal to 100 minus 16 will automatically, we know it is going to ultimately come 84M. So we have got the sale prices of all the three sellers for the item 2. Now fit it, average of item 2 by A and B is 3888. 68M plus XM by 2 is equal to 3888 is one thing that we have got. Keep it as such. Let us now move to the other one, seller B and seller C. For seller B and C, it is 4320. So we can write 84M plus XM by 2 is equal to 4320. This is what we have. Now we have two equations. And what do we have to find? Sale price of item 2 by seller C. Sale price can be found if we know the marked price. We need M. We don't need this X at all. This is not required. So if you have a presence of mind, we can subtract this first equation from the second one. What will happen is 84M minus 68M by 2. This XM by 2 and XM by 2 will get cancelled out. And this should be equal to this minus this, 10 minus 8, 2, 11 minus 8, 3, 12 minus 8, 4, 432. So you can just now do whatever way you can, maybe cancel, I'll follow it that 14 minus 8, 6, 16M by 2 is equal to 432. Therefore, M is equal to 432 by 8, which is equal to 54. And now sale price of item 3, item 2 by seller C. Therefore, the sale price by C is equal to 84 into M into 54, which we can calculate as 4536 rupees, which is the required answer. Let us move to the next question now. If the selling price of item 1 and item 3 by seller E are in the ratio 5:6, seller E, item 1 and item 3, both the discounts are not known to us. The selling price are in the ratio 5:6. If the seller earned a profit of 25%, which is rupees 750 on item 1 and 20% on item 3, then find the total profit by selling 1 and 3 together by the same seller. So on the face of it, it looks very complicated. So if the selling price of item 1 and 3 by the same seller, so let us write selling price of item 1 can be written as 5k, because the ratio is given, so we can write it as 5k. And selling price of item 3 can be written as 6k, the ratio is given. This is one thing very clear with us. Now he says, if the seller earned 25% on item 1, so cost price of item 1 is going to be 100 by 100 125 multiplied by the sale price of item 1, which is 5k. If you are not clear about how I converted this sale price into cost price, you will have to revise your profit and loss theory. I am not taking it here right now. So this one comes to 5 and this 25 and 4. So cost price comes equal to 4k. Then another thing he says is the seller earned a profit of rupees 750. This is important. Profit means sale price minus cost price. Sale price is 5k. Cost price we have found as 4k. This is given as 750. Therefore, k is equal to 750. That is one thing that we have immediately obtained. Now, another thing he says is on 20% profit is earned on item 3. So we can say cost price of item 3 is equal to, by the same story, 100 by 120 multiplied by the sale price, which is 6k, and this comes to 5k. This is what we have. We have now got cost price as 5k, cost price as 4k, sale price, and k. We are almost close to the answer. He says find the total profit by selling item 1 and 3 in rupees. So what is the cost price of item 1 and 3? 4k plus 5k, 9k. Cost is to be subtracted from sale price. Sale price is 6k plus 5k, 11k, which is equal to 2k, and k is already known as 750, which is equal to 1500 rupees, which is the required answer. So it was pretty simple. It looked very complicated. Let us move to the last question for this one. Now this question says cost price of item 3 is 60 rupees for all the sellers. This one. Cost price is same for all the sellers, and all of them marked the same product at 66.2/3% higher. So what I can do is cost price is 60 and marked price is this much higher. So it is 60 plus, now this will translate to 66 into 3 plus 2, 200 by 3% of 60. So this you can see will be 100. So marked price is 100 rupees and cost price is 60 rupees. For all the sellers, the cost is 60 and marked price is 100. Then to get a total profit of 80 rupees by all of the 5 sellers, combined profit, what is the minimum discount should be provided by seller E? Let the discount by seller E be X. The discount. So what will be the sale price? Sale price for this one is going to be 64 rupees because marked price is 100. 64 plus this one will be, you can check out, 67 plus 86 plus 84 plus 100 minus X. So the sale prices are basically 100 minus the discount, 100 minus 36, 64, 100 minus 33, 67, then 86, 84, and likewise 100 minus x. This figure we can total out too, so you can add them up. And on adding, we can see that this comes to 401 minus x. This is the combined sale price. The total cost price is equal to 641 multiplied by, there are 5 sellers, equal to 300. The total desired profit is 80. Therefore, 401 minus x minus 300 should be equal to 80, more than or equal to 80, at least 80 profit. So, which therefore, this will be 101 and minus 80 should be equal to x. Therefore, x should be equal to 121 rupees, which is the required answer. Sorry, not rupees, but percent.